So, this will be a performance about pre-established harmony. And there are some thoughts that I have gathered around this concept. And some of you probably know that it's related to philosophy. And our first part will be about mechanic causality. And this is related to a philosophical concept made by Leibniz. And Gottfried Wilhelm Leibniz was a German philosopher who contributed to metaphysics and actually in natural sciences too, and jurisprudence. He was a multi-scholar. And here's one key quotation by Leibniz, where he discusses his basic concept. But at this point, may I ask, is there anybody in the audience who understands French?
Harry?
Could you help me with this quotation? And maybe you come here, front. So, may I ask you to read it aloud?
In which language?
In French. It's you.
Okay. Harmonie préétablie. Les âmes sont des unités et les corps sont des multitudes. Mais les unités, quoiqu'elles soient indivisibles et sans partie, ne laissent de représenter des multitudes à peu près comme toutes les lignes de la circonférence se réunissent dans le centre.
Okay. Now, may I ask something? Thank you for reading this. Would you please roughly translate this in English? Not word by word, but only the basic idea.
Let's see.
I
have to think about it. So, pre-established harmony. The souls are the unities, or unité could be maybe singulars or some kind of solid components.
Right.
And the bodies are the plurals.
Yes.
So it must be the singulars, but the singulars who can be seen, that I don't really understand.
not dividable.
Not dividable.
Not dividable.
And
okay.
Received and without parts don't. Don't give the representation to the the multitudes, the plurals. But yeah, this is about like all the lines or directions of circumference something that reunite in the center.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
As Aapo explained, I don't myself understand French at all, but I hope that he explained this idea that there's one series, there's mind and body, and both represent a chain. So in mind there's that kind of chain of thoughts. Well, representation means like thought. You are having one thought, another thought, third thought, fourth thought, fifth thought, etc. And on the other hand, you have a second series. I call it body, but body means here like human body or some kind of like physical object anyway, or anybody. But there's then mechanical chain of causal connections, and they are also same kind of like series, but the question is that how are those connected? This is the question now. And a pre-established harmony is one like philosophical theory to answer this question. That they are not really connected, but there's some sort like they are going in the same synchronized pattern. Or so this is like causality of mechanical bodies. David Hume usually uses billiard as example because he's a British gentleman. So like billiard ball hitting one billiard ball, and that makes a mechanical chain. And then there's this attribute of thought that makes some kind of interferences, and they are not, one cannot reduce thought to that kind of mechanical thing or vice versa, but they are somehow connected. So this is what pre-established harmony basically is. Some kind of harmony that God has made between those things. And second part is a little bit more complicated. It's optical causality. This is actually a concept made by myself. So normally causality means like billiard ball that is hitting another billiard ball. But now we are thinking about like lens. Like I have eyeglasses, and this is like optical causality that if I take those glasses away, I hardly can recognize your faces, but when I put them back, everything is perfectly all right. And this is like, it happens every time, so it's causality. So now we can a little bit elaborate this idea so that we think about different kind of lenses, but now I would like to ask, is there somebody who understands German? Most of Finns understand some German, but
so then I'm the only one.
Well, we need to trust the youth, Johnny. So could you please read it out first?
Yeah. So Friedrich Nietzsche said, moralisch-optische Täuschung. Die Kennzeichen, welche man dem wahren Sein der Dinge gegeben hat, sind die Kennzeichen des Nichtseins, des Nichts. Man hat die wahre Welt aus dem Widerspruch zur wirklichen Welt aufgebaut. Eine scheinbare Welt in der Tat, insofern sie bloß eine moralisch-optische Täuschung ist. Götzendämmerung.
Yes, would you roughly translate this in English?
Okay. Moralic optical Täuschung.
Deception.
Huh?
Deception?
Deception. the signs which were supposed for the real being are the signs for the for the not being of the nothing. Man had built the real world out of the built the real world out of the conflict.
Contradiction.
To the real. The real world. Scheinbar, I don't know what scheinbar.
Something seems to be something.
Okay. A world that seems to be the. A world that seems, in fact, just optical, moralic
illusion.
Probably.
I know some German, but
I know perfectly. This German, you know better than me.
I'm not so sure about that, but as Johnny quoted Nietzsche, this optical causality means that, like, religion or some metaphysical system is like eyeglasses, and when I put them on, it really affects how I view reality or what is my perspective to reality. So it is causality in that sense that it is necessary. As necessary as I prop stone to the floor, it will happen every time, and it does some same laws. So in this sense, it's optical causality, and I guess that one cannot be without some kind of eyeglasses or lenses. We need that kind of like optics to somehow make the world understandable or significant. So this is to illustrate this idea that it's like basic idea of optical lens. There's ray of light coming from air, and then it's distracted like this. It happens every time, it's causal. As you can see. But always when we represent world with our eyes, it is somehow distracted, but we are so used to it that we think it's our world. This is Nietzsche's point. And
there is an exception for that also.
Please.
When the light comes straight, like in 90 degree, the angle is 90 degree, it doesn't,
it doesn't change the direction of rays. That's right, that's perspective of God, I guess.
Yeah,
nice comment. Okay. So last idea is organic causality, and now we have Spanish quotation, and is there somebody who understands Spanish in the audience?
No.
There is one. Okay, please. Could you read this quotation?
Una forma alternativa de definir a los seres vivos es mediante el concepto de autopoiesis. La idea es definir a los sistemas vivientes por su organización más que por un conglomerado de funciones. Un sistema se define como autopoiético cuando las moléculas producidas generan la misma red que las produjo y especifican su extensión.
Thank you very much. Could you somehow roughly translate this?
Okay.
Give your interpretation. Quite freely.
An alternative form to define the livable ends, the livable bodies, is through the concept of self-reproduction, the idea to define the livable systems for the organization more than for the conglomerate of functions. A system is defined as self-reproducible when the molecules.
I don't know Spanish at all. I don't. molecules. Yeah.
Yes. And the molecules produced are generating the same net that produce themselves and specifying their extension.
Thank you very much. Now I see what is inside of this quotation. So it's like all organisms, they have some kind of like mysterious ability to produce, like flowers produce leaves, and they do it automatically. And this is totally different compared to those billiard balls that hit each other. This is something that is growing from the earth and comes out. So this is maybe the highest point of causality, I guess. It is self-productive, so that you are reason for your own behavior or automatic system, so to say.
Google.
I don't know, actually. Some Spanish biologists, I guess. I don't remember their names. Let's watch some music, please.
Don't call me Gaga. No someone like that before. Don't look at me like that. You amaze me.
He ate my heart. He ate my heart.
Oh,
else? Anybody wants to share? Okay, that was it.